Hi guys, it's Sarah. What is up? Welcome back to my channel, or welcome to my channel if this is your first time here. Today's video revolves around self-care. So today is a little self-care day for me. I already showered, washed my hair, just finished blow drying. I have a clean bare face on, just moisturized my skin, did some exfoliation, and I'm keeping the self-care theme going today. So I'm going to be showing you guys my self-tan routine. I am obsessed with this self-tanner and the current routine that I am using. I've used other products in the past that just were not the best, and I think I found a product that I actually love to self-tan with. I thought this video was coming at the perfect time since obviously summer is now coming to an end. We're entering fall and winter months. I do live in Florida, so it's pretty much summer here year-round, but I thought this video would be helpful to those of my friends that live up north or just live somewhere where it's going to be really cold and not warm enough to go outside and tan for pretty much the next 6 months. But before we do jump into my self-tanning routine where I show you the products and how I apply the products all over my body, I do just want to talk about this perfume brand that I absolutely love called DOSSIER. I'm stoked right now because I do have two new scents from DOSSIER that I have not talked about here on my channel before. I have worked with DOSSIER in the past. I've made a few videos with them because I absolutely love and adore them, which is why I continue to work with them. If you haven't heard of DOSSIER yet, you are seriously missing out. If you are anyone who likes to smell good, if you like to smell expensive, if you like to have heads turn when you walk into the room because you're smelling that good, then you need to know about DOSSIER. So like I said, DOSSIER is a perfume company, but the unique thing about this brand is they make luxury-inspired fragrances for a fraction of the cost. The two fragrances that I have here are Floriental Brown Sugar and Fruity Magnolia. I honestly didn't even want to talk about this perfume with you guys because I love it so much. It is my favorite perfume that I do have right now. The Floriental Brown Sugar, without a doubt, is the best smelling perfume that I have right now. It's inspired by a YSL fragrance, and when you do pick out your fragrances online, they do send you these cute little cards with your perfume that have all the information that you need on the perfume, like the notes that are in it, what perfume brand it is inspired by, the concentration, and basically just how it works. I literally wear their perfumes every single day. They last so long, and they seriously just smell so good. I'm gonna make sure to link DOSSIER in my description box below so you can go check out their website and see all of the fragrances that they do have that are inspired by your favorite luxury brands. I do have a discount code if you do want to go check them out. I promise you will not be disappointed. But really, I did not want to tell you guys about Floriental Brown Sugar because it is amazing and I don't want it to sell out. So like I said, I've already had a little bit of a self-care day going this morning already. So I have showered, washed my hair. I'm not wearing any makeup because we are going to be applying this self-tanner to our face. I did exfoliate my skin everywhere very, very well. And then I followed up with moisturizing as normal. And I've let my moisturizer soak into the skin for about 2 to 3 hours now. If you are going to be self-tanning at home, or maybe you have self-tanned in the past and it's never really turned out great, maybe it's turned out streaky or patchy, make sure you always exfoliate well beforehand and moisturize as well. The self-tanning product that I've actually been using is by the brand El Maquillage. I do have this little self-tanning kit, which comes with a glove. Love that, don't have to buy that separately. And then it does come with their El Maquillage self-tanning foam. If you're looking for a nice, easy self-tanner, this is the one that I can recommend without a doubt. It is dermatologist tested, which is so important if I'm applying anything on my skin. And not only that, it smells amazing. It smells like a tropical beach. It takes about 10 minutes to dry. It does not leak onto your sheets or your clothes. I cannot say enough good things about this self-tanner. It just makes you feel extremely confident. It gives you a really overall even skin tone and just a beautiful natural tan. And the last thing that does come in this little kit that I have right here is this kabuki brush so that I can apply the product to my face as well as the back of my hands. Let's go ahead and jump into this little routine. I'm gonna go ahead and put my hair back. I like to start from the top all the way down. I basically start at my face, then I will do my whole body all the way down to my feet. You can do this however you prefer. I just find it easier to go from top to bottom, just to make sure that everything does apply evenly and nicely. First things first, I like to shake it really well before pumping it onto the brush. I feel like this is extremely dangerous. I have a white rug under my camera, so I really hope this product does not get onto the rug when I pump it out. But anything for the shot, right? That's what the product does look like on the brush whenever you do pump it out. I use about 2 to 3 pumps when I do pump it for my entire face, and I like to start just in even strokes down my skin. This is gonna be quite hard to do without a mirror. I do have my little viewfinder, but it doesn't help that much. And then once I feel like the product is dispersed on my face, I will just go in circular motions to blend it in. It looks very beautiful on the skin. Like I said, I have been using this as my tanning routine, so I know that I already love the product. What I also really like about this product as well is it does not smell. So you know, a lot of the time some self-tanning products can just be overpowering, I guess, to say it nicely. It just doesn't smell all that great, especially if you're gonna apply it on your face. And sometimes products are just really sticky and they're just not a good experience. I have not had a negative experience with this product at all. I love how natural it is, and that's pretty much all I can say. It's just a really great product. I just finished applying the product all over my face. I did bring it down my neck a little bit, but not all the way, because I'm going to go in with the mitt when I do my body, and I will get the rest of my neck then. A tip that I do have when you are using this mousse, or really any self-tanner that you don't want to go everywhere, whenever you do switch between pumps, I always close the lid and reshake. Closing the lid is what I'm trying to emphasize on here, because you don't want that product going everywhere. I'm basically going to take this cute little mitt that we have here. I feel like a snowman with this on. I don't know why, but we're going to take the mitt and we're basically going to do about 5 to 6 pumps. But if you don't know how the color is going to look on you, I do recommend maybe doing 3 to 4. I do like to start up my arm and then go all the way to my chest and basically just start blending in circular motions. And I do like putting this on my back as well. So this is where you are going to go in and make sure you get the rest of your neck. I always make sure I get that elbow really good, because you know you got all those little nooks and crannies and you want the product to go everywhere. I'm going to do the back of my hand lightly, but I always go in with a kabuki brush to do that anyway. And I just find that circular motions do work best for me. It just makes everything really nicely blended. Now I'm gonna switch hands and I'm gonna put a little bit more product on this mitt. Basically do the same thing on this side. Now that my top area is done, I'm basically going to move on to my stomach and then my legs. I feel like my skin looks so glowy right now, so I went ahead and did my stomach. I do just want to mention, don't forget your back. I don't know if I mentioned that already. I feel like that kind of goes without saying, but if you haven't self-tanned before, then you might not know. But yes, try as hard as you can to get all of your back and your lower back. Now let's finish this little self-tan off with the legs. It only takes about 10 minutes to dry, so it dries very quickly. That literally took me 5 minutes from head to toe, and I am done. I will be tan like this for at least 7 days. It's gonna look a little bit different tomorrow once the product has fully developed after 8 hours. If you do end up trying out this product for your self-tanning routine, let me know your experience in the comments below. I hope you did enjoy this video. If you did, give it a huge thumbs up. Make sure you subscribe to my channel, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye guys. I just applied this like 20 minutes ago, and I feel like my body is glowing. She is a tan goddess.